You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Thursday, the 27th of January, 2022, third week in ordinary time. And today we keep the memorial of Angela Merici. Angela was born in northern Italy in 1474. Her desire to provide better education and Christian formation, especially for girls, led her to found the Ursulines, a group of women religious to care for girls. She died in 1540. And definitely today we pray for the Ursuline sisters and all those who take the spirituality of Angela Merici, helping us that through our intercessions, they may remain true to their calling. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Tanaka Mahachi, taking the first reading of today, child of Christopher Makoto from Harare, Zimbabwe. And taking the responsorial psalm is Tadiwa Mabata, child of Natsai and Remigio Mabata from Francistown, Botswana. And proclaiming the gospel passage of today is Father Alfred Maman from Zaria Diocese in Nigeria. Let us pray. May the Virgin Saint Angela never fail to commend us to your compassion, O Lord, we pray, that following the lessons of our charity and prudence, we may hold fast to your teaching and express it in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Who am I, O Lord God, and what is my house? A reading from the second book of Samuel, 2 Samuel 7, verses 18 to 19, 24 to 29. After Nathan had spoken to David, the king went in and said before the Lord, and said, Who am I, O Lord God, and what is my house, that you have brought me thus far? And yet this was a small thing in your eyes. O Lord God, you have spoken also of your servant's house for a great while to come, and have shown me future generations. O Lord God, and you did establish for yourself your people Israel to be your people forever. And you, O Lord, did become their God. And now, O Lord God, confirm forever the word which you have spoken concerning your servant and concerning his house. And do as you have spoken, and your name will be magnified forever, saying, The Lord of hosts is God over Israel, and the house of your servant David will be established before you. For you, O Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, have made this revelation to your servant, saying, I will build you a house. There where your servant has found courage to pray this prayer to you. And now, O Lord God, you are God, and your words are true, and you have promised this good thing to your servant. Now, therefore, may it please you to bless the house of your servant, that it may continue forever before you For you, O Lord God, have spoken, and with your blessing shall the house of your servant be blessed forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm. Psalm 132, verses 1 to 2, 3 to 5, 11, 12, 13 to 14. The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
O Lord, remember David and all the hardships he endured, the oath he swore to the Lord, his vow to the strong one of Jacob.
The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
I will not enter my house, nor go to the bed where I rest. I will give no sleep to my eyes. To my eyelids I will give no slumber, till I find a place for the Lord, a dwelling for the strong one of Jacob.
The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
The Lord swore an oath to David. He will not go back on his word. A son, the fruit of your body, will I set upon your throne.
The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
If your sons hold fast to my covenant and my laws that I have taught them, their sons in turn shall sit on your throne from age to age.
The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
For the Lord has chosen Zion, he has desired it for his dwelling. This is my resting place from age to age. Here have I chosen to dwell.
The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David.
A lamb is brought in to be put on a stand. The measure you give will be the measure you get. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mark Gospel chapter 4, verses 21 to 25. At that time, Jesus said to the crowd, "Is a lamb brought in to be put under a bushel or under a bed and not on a stand? For there is nothing hidden except to be made manifest, nor is anything secret except to come to light. If any man has ears to hear, let him hear." And he said to them, "Take heed what you hear. The measure you give will be the measure you get, and still more will be given you. For to him who has, will more be given, and from him who has not, even what he has will be taken away." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are back to the second book of Samuel. We paused for the past 2 days because we had consecutive feasts. We had the conversion of St. Paul on Tuesday, and we had Timothy and Titus on Wednesday. Because of this, we could not know what was happening to David. Now, from where we left, David became a king. And after becoming a king, he grew greater and greater because the Lord was with him. A number of things happened. Fast forward, David was getting older and he realized that he was not going to have a proper heir to the throne, and he didn't know what was going to happen because the brothers were fighting among themselves, and who it is that was going to take care of the kingdom once he was gone. He had defeated a lot of people. He had indeed done a lot, killed a lot of people. And after settling, after conquering kingdoms, he now called his spiritual director, Nathan, and said, "You know, I think I have to do something. The Ark of the Covenant sits in a tent, and here I am in the house of cedar. Why can't I do something for God? Why can't I do something for the one who did so much for me? I want to build a house for my God." And Nathan for a while said, go ahead. But after thinking about it and after getting the inspirations from the Lord, Nathan came back and told David, no, you are not going to build a house for the Lord. The Lord said, he is the one going to build a house for you. You are just a mere shepherd. He took you away from shepherding animals and he gave you the responsibility of shepherding human beings. You were elevated by God and God who elevated you knows what he is doing. So don't worry about the heir to your throne. God will establish a kingdom. God is going to build a house for you. And the house he's going to build is a dynasty which will have no end. See how much favor God has shown you. And after listening to this, David was able to say what we are hearing today. After Nathan had spoken to David, King David went in and sat before the Lord and said, who am I, O Lord God, and what is my house that you have brought me thus far? We only start growing in our spirituality when we understand that we don't have anything we can call a good beginning. We are all taken from nowhere to somewhere. God takes us from our wretched state into a state that is dignified. David realizes this, that I have nothing to boast about. Everything I have become is all because of you, Lord. Those people who boast of what they have become are those who think that whatever they have become is their effort. No, it's not your effort. I am telling you, there are many people who have stepped where you have stepped and they have not reached where you have reached. God has made it so for you. And he is the one you have to go into a corner and pray to and acknowledge that he is the source of everything that you are, of everything that you have. This is the faith we are asked to have, the faith of David, recognizing that he is the one who has brought us thus far. If he is the one who has brought us thus far, then we have nothing to boast about and we have nothing to show off to other people or even to look down upon others. But understand that God favors us in different forms and in different ways. And as he favors us, we should not mistreat or look down upon others who are not yet as favored as you are. They are human beings like you, and they too deserve respect. David understood this, and he is now able to pray to God and thank him for all the graces that God has bestowed upon his life. Therefore, your servant has found courage to pray this prayer to you. And now, O Lord God, you are God and your words are true and you have promised this good thing to your servant. Now, therefore, may it please you to bless the house of your servant so that it may continue forever before you. For you, O Lord God, have spoken, praying that this house may continue forever before God. That is why, because of this, David became the ancestor of Jesus because of this prayer. You don't know whose ancestor you are going to become when you solidify your house with this assurance from the Lord, saying, Lord, may you take care of this house. May you take care of this family. May you take care of the children to be born after me, the children of my children and the children of the children of my children, that a generation may stay that fears you. That's what we have to pray for. That is how our prayer should be like. Praying for future generations to stand in the path of God, to remain in the path of God. The gospel passage of today focuses on the fact that God wants us to be shining stars in our faith and in our deeds. Jesus has just given the parable of the sower and explained it. is teaching the people by the Sea of Galilee. And along the sea, as he is teaching, he realizes there are some people who will follow the word and others who won't. Because some will be timid to show the good things that God does in their lives. Others will be forthcoming. Those who are planted in the word of God are able to bear much fruit. But there are others to whom the word is just a by-the-way thing, and they are like the seed that falls on rocky ground where it had not much soil, and immediately it sprang up, since it had no depth of soil. When the sun rises, it would be scorched, and since it had no root, it withers away. And it says, these are the ones who just hear the word and they do not listen to it. Now, if you want the word that you hear to settle in your heart, make sure that you come out in the open to share the word that you listen to. And so he says, is a lamp brought in to be put under a basket or under a bed and not on a stand? For nothing is hidden except to be made manifest, nor is anything secret except to come to light. So pay attention to what you hear, because you cannot just grow in your faith if you are not paying attention to what you hear. And paying attention to what you hear is coming out in the light and sharing that word that you hear. Because when you share, you grow in your faith. When you share, you produce fruits. And that's the reason for forming those daily bread groups. And that's the reason for forming those daily bread groups which are interactive. They are interactive not to just greet each other. They are interactive in order for us to let the light shine out there for people to hear what we believe in. For people to know how the word is solidifying itself within us. So that we may bear fruit. Fruit that lasts. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Thursday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I your bed.